A major change in U.S. health policy this morning. Health and Human Services Secretary Robert F. Kennedy Jr. announcing he will shift nearly $500 million of federal funding away from the development of mRNA technology-based vaccines. Now, Kennedy is a longtime vaccine skeptic. He's already gutted a vaccine advisory committee. He's cut billions to state health agencies and canceled an ad campaign for the flu shot. Here's what he says about this latest decision.
After reviewing the science and consulting top experts at NIH and FDA, HHS has determined that mRNA technology poses more risks than benefits for these respiratory viruses. That's why, after extensive review, BARDA has begun the process of terminating these 22 contracts, totaling just under $500 million.
Many scientists say mRNA technology is the best way to protect Americans against another pandemic, with one immunologist calling this decision a, quote, bad day for science. And joining us now is Dr. Paul Offit, director of the Vaccine Education Center at the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia and the co-inventor of the rotavirus vaccine. Dr. Offit, your reaction to this latest move, and what does it mean for vaccine development going forward?
Well, it's a sad day for science in this country. The mRNA vaccines saved our lives. It was estimated that in 2021, you were 12 times more likely to be hospitalized and die if you didn't get a vaccine than if you did. In 2022, you were 6 times more likely to be hospitalized and die. It's a phenomenal technology, and it was remarkably safe. I mean, I'm on the FDA Vaccine Advisory Committee. When we looked at those data in December of 2020, we were only looking at 35,000 people who had received that vaccine. All of us were worried that the other shoe was going to drop, that there was going to be a much more serious side effect that we would see when millions of people, and now hundreds of millions of people, were vaccinated. And that wasn't true. Although the vaccine could cause myocarditis, meaning inflammation of the heart muscle, it was rare and it was transient and self-resolving and short-lived, as distinct from the virus, which could cause myocarditis, which could cause you to be hospitalized, go to the intensive care unit, and die. It is a remarkable technology, and not only for COVID, and not only for infectious diseases, but also for cancer, for gene therapy, and eliminating all of this research and development at BARDA is a tragic mistake that is not based on a science-based decision.
I mean, Kennedy says that these mRNA vaccines just aren't effective enough against upper respiratory infections like COVID and flu, because those viruses can mutate and then the vaccine's no longer good. Here's how he explained it.
As the pandemic showed us, mRNA vaccines don't perform well against viruses that infect the upper respiratory tract. Here's the problem. mRNA only codes for a small part of the viral proteins, usually a single antigen. One mutation and the vaccine becomes ineffective. This dynamic drives a phenomenon called antigenic shift, meaning that the vaccine paradoxically encourages new mutations and can actually prolong pandemics as the virus constantly mutates to escape.
Dr. Offit, what do you say to that?
So this virus mutates. When the virus first entered China and then left China, it had its first mutation, the so-called D614G variant, which was much more contagious, swept through Asia, swept through Europe. Then it mutated again and had the Alpha variant. Then it mutated again and had the Delta variant. That had nothing to do with vaccination. Vaccines weren't available yet. This is just a virus that mutates. So when he says that by having a single protein vaccine, that's a problem, and he's argued, well, let's just use the whole virus. Let's use the whole killed virus, which is what China did. That's how they made their vaccine, and that vaccine was less effective. It didn't induce as high of an antibody response, and it didn't induce as the longer-term immunity. So he doesn't know what he's talking about. He sort of throws out these scientific terms, which makes it sound like he knows what he's talking about, but he doesn't know what he's talking about.
He says shifting the funding is going to help develop safer, broader vaccine platforms that remain effective even as viruses mutate. Do you support that goal?
And which platforms are those? I mean, we have been trying to make a universal flu vaccine for the last 50 years. Flu mutates every year from one year to the next. Actually, it mutates during the same winter season. And we have been unsuccessful at doing that. So if he has a magic formula for being able to stop viruses from mutating, I'd like to hear what that is. I just think he makes things up.
Dr. Paul Offit, thanks for giving us the science, the facts. I know we can always count on you for that. Thank you.